Hey guys, how's it going? This is the Helpful Lockpicker here, and welcome back to another Locksport update. Welcome back to my third installment of Locksport Update. Locksport Update is a fun little series that I made to try to help update everyone on things that I'm working on and give the community a great place to share some of the things that they're working on. I really encourage everyone to share in the comments below anything that they're excited about, anything they're working on, and anything they'd like me to share in the next Locksport Update. Well, I'm going to start off this Locksport Update by giving myself a little congratulations. I still cannot believe I have reached where I am today. On October 22nd of 2018, I hit my 1 million view mark, and that is just such an incredible feat. I just cannot believe it. That is so many people to have watched my videos. That is a huge number, and just thank you so much to everyone that has helped get me to where I am. And on top of that, just 4 days later, I was able to reach my 10,000th subscriber, and wow, I just cannot believe 1 million views, 10,000 subscribers, and still growing. This is a really great community. YouTube is a really fun platform to share a lot of your knowledge on, and this has just been a really fun channel to watch. Thank you again to everyone that has helped support my channel by sharing, liking, subscribing, clicking the notification bell, donating through my PayPal links, and just being really great members of the community, always commenting on my videos, sharing, and just making this a lot of fun. So that is enough about me. What I want to do is just go through a few things that have been exciting towards me and some of the stuff the community has done that they would like to share. So this week, I would like to say that I am very excited about the video I made a few weeks ago on my lock decoding video, the one showing you how to decode a dial combination lock. These are really fun, and I really recommend anyone check that video out if you'd like to try them out. It is such a fun thing to do. It's a little bit different than picking locks, but it is a really fun skill to hone. And from that, another thing I received this week was something that was really cool. Jason Carlson reached out to me, and you can see in the video of the unboxing, he wanted to send me some picks. I got these three picks he sent me, and wow, they are really fun to use. I have this one that I called Psychedelic. It has a really nice profile on it, and it has a really nice wooden handle. This one's the Brown Derby. It has a little bit of a steeper hook. It has a thinner thickness. It is about 18 thousandths from the 25 thousandths. And then I have the Pink Flamingo. This one was made for Breast Cancer Awareness Month, and this one is a lot of fun to use, and it is pretty fun to look at. So Jason Carlson, thank you again for sharing your skill with me and being willing to make me some really cool custom picks. I'm still hoping to do a video on these down the road to give them a review individually, and that will be a lot of fun to do. Another few things that I am excited about is the Board Lock Picker was very generous, and he reached out to me, and he was willing to try to make some keys to these combination locks. When you look at the combination locks, some of them come with a keyway on the back that you can see on these ones. These ones are so if they're used in something like a school system or something, that you'll be able to bypass the combo and get into them for an emergency access. When you look at the back of the locks, they're all stamped with the little code here, and you can go through the websites, and there are some websites you can join, which the Board Lock Picker has, and you can run the code, and you can get the key blank that you need and the bidding code on the key, and you can cut one. So what the Board Lock Picker did for me was he made me some keys. On this black master lock, you can see it has a keyway in the back, and the key that he made me works very well, and it opens up the lock without any problem. Let me just make sure I'm inserting the key all the way here. There we go. So it was pretty cool that he was able to just go on a website and be able to look up the key blank you need and the bidding code and be able to just code cut one. And this one has some pretty good bidding on it. That wouldn't be the easiest lock to pick with that really long key pin in the front. And when you look at the keyway here, this is such a small little keyway, it's going to be pretty hard to be able to get a pick in there anyway, so it is really cool to have the key. Now, what he did was he did the same thing for this one, but for some reason the blank that he bought was just a 5-pin blank and it was too long, so when I initially inserted the key, I bent it because I turned it expecting it to open, and it didn't. As you can see, the key's a little bit bent here. What I tried to do was take a Dremel and cut off the tip here, because the bitting should be okay for the first four. But unfortunately, at this time, this key is not working. It does fit the keyway, but it does not unlock the lock. It does probably need a little bit more filing down. But either way, the board lock picker wants me to send this lock out to him, and he's going to try to make a key that works. And that will be a really cool video for you guys to check out. If you haven't checked out the board lock picker already, he's a really great picker. He's a pretty cool locksmith, and he does a lot of interesting content. And I'll put a link up on the top here to his channel. He is really worth checking out. Another thing I have coming my way soon is, on the last LockSport update I made, Noctis Modus sent me a message saying that he's really into making cutaway locks, and he was willing to make me one. I asked him to make me a cutaway lock that has a pretty open keyway that would be really great for using as an instructional aid. A lot of my videos you've seen me use a Schlage lock, which are pretty easy to open, but sometimes you don't want to deal with that keyway when you're trying to teach concepts. You want it to be as easy as possible. So I have that lock coming in the mail, and thank you again to Noctis Modus for sending that to me. I'll put a link up to his channel up here. He's a really great guy and worth checking out as well. I also got back in the mail recently the American Lock 5300 series that Lock Noob wanted to try out. He really showed me up on his picking. He got this lock open several times, much faster than me. But it is really cool to see someone be able to open up a lock that you have worked on yourself. I'm really glad to have this lock back, and it was a lot of fun to work on. If you want to see me opening up this lock, I will put a link in the description below, and you can check this out. This is a really cool lock. And moving forward, I was the lucky winner of a few locks from Scruffy's giveaway. If you remember in the last video, I told you how Scruffy was doing 40 locks in 40 days, where he was filming a video every single day. I was able to win two of his locks that you see here. I have this Yale, and then I also have this Abyss. And these were pretty cool locks, and I'm going to try to pick them, and I'll see if anyone wants to try them out after I am getting them open on video. And also, I believe I won his 100 subscriber giveaway, which is pretty cool, and I'm waiting for that to come in as well. Scruffy, once again, thank you so much for everything you do. You have some really great content, and he's a really cool guy worth checking out, and I'll put a link up on the top to him as well. So some of the community stuff that was shared in my last video is that some people are just working on some really cool things. Dark Arts Lockpicking shared in the comments that he's working on some floating wafer pins, which will be pretty cool for some challenge locks. And when he's able to get those made, that would be really cool to see. And hopefully he'll get those circulating in the community. People are always so creative with their challenge locks, they can make them very difficult. And it is always nice to see people working on some really cool custom pins. Thumper is a really great guy as well, who just made his first challenge lock. And on top of that, just reached his 50th subscriber. Thumper is always very active in the community, and he's a pretty cool channel worth checking out, and I'll put a link up to his channel as well on the top. Thumper, congratulations on hitting your 50th subscriber and also making your first challenge lock. That is a really, really great thing to do, and I really encourage everyone to be able to try out some challenge locks and get involved in the community. Another cool channel is Pestilence. Pestilence is really doing some cool work. Some of his videos that I have seen, he really seems to focus on a lot of older locks. When I say older locks, I don't mean locks that are 100 years old. I mean locks that are a few hundred years old. One of the videos he's going to be working on soon, and you can see a little clip of it before, is that he's working on a 9th to 11th century Viking padlock, and this lock is very, very worn, and he's going to start working on restoring that. That is going to be a really, really cool video to see, because you have to be very careful when you're restoring locks, and that'd be really nice to see him be able to bring some life back to such an old lock. That is some really old technology. It's a really beautiful lock, and Pestilence, I am really happy to see that you are trying to bring back some of the life to these locks. You have a really nice collection, and thank you for sharing them. If anyone wants to check that out, I'll put a link up on the top here too. I can only do about 5 links, so if I have run out, I will put them in the description. But either way, guys, thank you so much for checking out all these channels. The final channel I'm going to mention that mentioned in the comments last time is BlackDolphin90. He is a pretty cool channel, and he said that he's going to be working on a GG lock. He's been working on a lot of stock locks, and that will be cool to see when he gets his GG opened up. So I'm going to try to put a link to all these channels in the description, and just thank you to everyone that has been watching all the various channels that have been watching my channel, and it's just been helping this community grow. All these channels are really fun to watch, and every subscription really makes a big difference. Thank you to subscribing to all of the smaller channels and helping the community grow as a whole. So today this has just been my LockSport update. I really like to share some of the stuff that I've been working on and some of the stuff that the community is working on. I'm very fortunate to be where I am today. I really enjoy being part of the community, and just thank you to everyone for checking out this video. If you have any questions or suggestions, please leave them in the comments below. If you enjoyed this video and you'd like to see more like it, please subscribe. As always, thank you so much for checking out this video. I hope you all have a great day, and just thank you so much for checking this out.